the easy to avoid two-factor loss risk. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If at the end of this video you find that it was helpful and you're somewhere that has a like button, would you hit that please? It actually helps not only me, but it helps other people who are looking for answers as they search the internet. So I'm a big believer in two-factor authentication, as are a lot of security professionals. Two-factor authentication adds essentially something you have, like a phone or a dongle or something else, to what you know, your password, in order to be able to sign in or log in to one of your online accounts. The problem, of course, is what happens if something you have becomes something you've lost? In other words, what happens when you lose your second factor, be it your phone or that dongle or that YubiKey or whatever else it is you're using for two-factor authentication? What happens when you lose it? Well, the short answer is it's really not that big a deal as long as you've prepared for it beforehand. Now, many services will walk you through the preparation steps beforehand, and it is then on you to make sure that those steps are always up to date. We'll talk about that in a moment. But the bottom line is that there are things that need to be in place before you lose your second factor that will allow you to regain access to your account, perhaps a little bit more cumbersomely, perhaps with a little bit more effort required, but even without your second factor. One approach is that at the time you set up your two-factor authentication, once you associate either your dongle or your smartphone app or your YubiKey or something else with the online service that you are using, you will then also be prompted to save something. It may be recovery codes, it may be a special key, it may be something else. It is something that you then want to save in a safe and secure location because it will take the place of your second factor should you lose the second factor. For example, you may be presented with an array of what are called one-time use codes. You can use those each one time and one time only, should you not have your second factor with you. It's important, of course, that you keep those codes safe, that you put them somewhere safe and secure so that they don't fall into the wrong hands. When you need them, yep, it may be more cumbersome than simply typing in your second factor number, but your ability to retrieve these codes and then use these codes will do the thing, will allow you to prove that you are who you say you are, even though you don't necessarily have the second factor in your possession. The other approach, and this is one that honestly, people overlook all the time, even if they're not using two-factor authentication. Many services use your traditional account recovery process if you've lost your second factor. What that means is you follow the path that essentially says, I've lost my password, or you'll be directed down the same path as if you had lost your password. You'll then be required to respond to a code sent to your mobile number, or respond to an email sent to your email address, or something else that allows you to prove that you are the rightful account holder and therefore be allowed to log into your account. The problem, of course, is that people don't keep those things up to date. They use an email account that they no longer have access to. They use a phone number that they no longer have access to. Those are, in a very real sense, second factors. They are something you have access to, something that you prove is in your possession that allows you to confirm that you are who you say you are and should be allowed back into the account. Once you get back into the account, of course, the first thing you can do then is turn off two-factor authentication or immediately associate your replacement two-factor authentication device. But the bottom line is you either need those recovery codes, your alternate email, your alternate phone, or something that would allow you to recover the account in general, regardless of whether or not you were using two-factor authentication, in order to be able to get into your account if you've lost your second factor. As long as those are in place, as long as those are kept up to date, you'll always be able to get into your account even if you've lost your second factor. For links related to this topic, for updates, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/17345. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.